Welcome back to this video where I'm going to talk about two more advanced BGP topics, and that's local preference and multi-exit discriminator known as MED. I've covered the basics of the Border Gateway Protocol known as BGP in a previous video, and in this video I'm going to build on those concepts, so let's get started. You'll probably remember this visual from the BGP 101 lesson. I talked about how BGP can be used to exchange routing information between autonomous systems known as AS. Each site is allocated an AS number or ASN, and it uses this to construct routing paths showing how to reach every site from every other. Now this works fine on its own where there's only one path between ASNs or where there's only one exit point for each system. At this level though, you'll need to understand how this can be enhanced. So let's take a look at both local preference and multi-exit discriminator in turn. And we'll start with local preference. So let's zoom in a little and add some complexity. Now the first change that we've made is to add an extra router at the Alice Springs site. It's become more important to the business, and so now the top router has the connection to Brisbane and the bottom router has the connection to Adelaide. We've also added an entirely new site, Tasmania, and it's connected to the rest of the network via a link from Brisbane as well as a shorter link from Adelaide. Now I just want to mention for any geography fans, I could be really wrong about these distances, but this is a technical video, not a geography video. Now Alice Springs has become a much more complex site, and so we've also restructured the routers, adding an extra set designed for routing within the autonomous system. And these routers are connected to the border routers independently. So we have IBGP running internally and EBGP running externally. So what does this mean in terms of external routing at Alice Springs? Well, we have the same set of routes as shown on the previous screen for Alice Springs. So we have a route for Brisbane, which is 10.16.0.0/16 going direct to Brisbane. And we have a route for Adelaide, which is 10.17.0.0/16 going direct to Adelaide. And we also have two less efficient routes for Brisbane, the first going via Adelaide and the second going via Adelaide and Tasmania. Now, strictly speaking, Adelaide would probably only advertise its best route to Brisbane, and so you'd probably only see the top blue route, but I wanted to add this to give you a full overview of the routing topology. What we would also have is a new route for Tasmania, so 10.19.0.0/16 going via Adelaide, and a route for Tasmania again, only this time going via Brisbane. Now note how for both of these the AS path length is the same, so from BGP's perspective we have two equal length routes, so the same priority. Now I want to talk about how we can use local preference. So what is it, when is it used, and why does it matter? Local preference allows you to choose outbound paths for a given destination, so it's a feature which is used for outbound traffic from you to somewhere else, and it's also internal only. It only functions inside of your AS, in this case, inside Alice Springs. It is exchanged internally with routers within your autonomous system, but it's not exchanged externally with other autonomous systems, which makes sense because it's for outgoing traffic from your AS to other ASs. The other important thing about local preference is that it does win against AS path for route choice. It's the highest priority when comparing these two, so if you have two routes, both the same length AS path, then local preference can be used by you to determine which to use. The default is that every route has a local preference of 100, and the path with the highest local preference is preferred for traffic between two autonomous systems. So how would this work with this example? Well, we have all of these potential routes between our sites, and all of them have a local preference right now of 100, because that's the default. Consider if we're on the Alice Springs site, and we're connected to this new router and we're sending data to Tasmania. Right now, the traffic has two routes to get to Tasmania. It can go via the top router to Brisbane and then to Tasmania, or it can go via the bottom router to Adelaide and then to Tasmania. From BGP's perspective, these are equal, because they're all the same length AS path. As a network admin of Alice Springs, we might have reason to preference one of these routes. Maybe we don't want to use the Brisbane site as an intermediary, or, and you might remember this from the BGP 101 video, maybe the link between Alice Springs and Brisbane is slow. In this case it is. It's a 5 meg satellite link, whereas the link to Adelaide is a 1 gig fibre connection. So from BGP's perspective, they're equal, but from a performance perspective, they aren't. What we can do is increase the local preference of the route via Adelaide, maybe changing the value from 100 to 200. In this case, because this is a higher value, it's preferred, so this route will be chosen versus the one via Brisbane. And to reiterate, this would be the case even if the AS path was shorter versus the other. Local preference always wins against AS path. So even if the AS path suggests taking one route, but the local preference says the other, then local preference will always win. So to summarise, local preference is for influencing traffic leaving your autonomous system. It's advertised internally only, not externally. Other autonomous systems don't know about your local preference and they don't care. There's a default value of 100, and higher values mean routes are more preferred, and this overrides the length of AS path, so it gives you ultimate control of how traffic exits your autonomous systems. Okay, so let's move on and talk about multi-exit discriminator, known as MED, and for that we need to slightly adjust the architecture again. So this architecture looks a little different. I've removed Tasmania from the architecture entirely and expanded the Brisbane site. It now has two routers, router 1 and router 2, connecting to a routing pair at Alice Springs, router 1 and router 2. Adelaide is connected to Alice Springs but not to Brisbane directly. The network link between Alice Springs router 1 and Brisbane router 1 is this same slow 5 meg connection. The new link between Brisbane router 2 and Alice Springs router 2 is a 1 gig connection. This means, and this is a simplification because I want to keep the diagram as clutter-free as I can, that in Brisbane we have these routes. It knows about itself, so 10.16.0.0/16. It knows about Alice Springs, so 10.18.0.0/16, via both router 1 and router 2, and it considers them equal. And it knows about Adelaide, so 10.17.0.0/16, through Alice Springs router 1 and router 2. And again, it considers both of those as equal. And while they might be equal from a BGP perspective, we know practically they aren't, because one of them is a 5 meg connection and the other is a 1 gig connection. Now at the Alice Springs site, things are similar. It knows about Adelaide via its connection directly to Adelaide, and it knows about Brisbane via both Brisbane router 1 and router 2, and it considers both of those to be equal. Now just to make things easier, I'm going to highlight the routes on the Alice Springs route table, just to highlight which connection is which. So the dotted line is the slow and the solid line is the fast. Now, multi-exit discriminator, also known as MED or metric, is a way that you, as an admin, can influence which path is used for given routes that you advertise by your neighbours. So in this example, if the Alice Springs admin wanted Brisbane to use a specific path, then MED can be used to influence that. It's used when an autonomous system has multiple links to another autonomous system, as is the case between Alice Springs and Brisbane in this example. And why it's awesome is that you can use it to influence the routing behavior of a neighbor without making any specific arrangements with them. ASPath takes priority over MED, and so MED is only used when you have equal length paths between neighbors, and then the route with the lowest MED value wins, with zero being the lowest. Now, I've seen many routing implementations which assume zero if an MED value isn't present, and this can confuse things. From a conceptual point of view, you should view MED as increasing the MED value to deprioritize a route. So when you increase the MED, you deprioritize that path for your neighbors. So let's say that we have a zero MED for all of our routes. Let's assume that we have no local preference set. This means ASPath is used first, and because this is equal for links between Alice Springs and Brisbane, the links are treated as equal. Now, because all of the MED values are the same, we don't differentiate on this either. Now, BGP has a long list of ways to prioritize routes, and so make sure you check out my video on BGP prioritization if you haven't already. Right now, let's just assume that they are equal, even though this isn't strictly true, as the IP addresses of the routers will be used to prioritize if everything else is equal. But let's ignore that for a moment and say that they are currently equal. Well, if you're the network admin at the Alice Springs site and you want to ensure that the slower 5 meg connection isn't used, what you can do is take any route advertisements that you make to Brisbane, including the ones that you've learned from Adelaide, and increase the MED value for those via router 1. You change the MED to 10 for those links, and notice what this means for the Brisbane route table. Both routes coming via Alice Springs router 1, so the one for Alice Springs directly via router 1 and the one for Adelaide via Alice Springs router 1, they both have a higher MED value than the routes via router 2, which are set to null or zero depending on the implementation. And this means that traffic from Brisbane to Alice Springs directly or Adelaide will move via Alice Springs router 2 over the 1 gig connection. Now, it's important to realise though that this doesn't affect traffic in the other direction. Any traffic from Adelaide via Alice Springs to Brisbane or from Alice Springs to Brisbane directly will still have the option of using 2 equal links. MED affects incoming traffic, not outgoing. It's the way to influence traffic coming into your site. As the Alice Springs site admin, you could, if it mattered, use local preference to ensure outgoing traffic goes via the faster link. But the Brisbane admin could also use MED to affect the routing behaviour of Alice Springs towards Brisbane. The Brisbane admin could increase the MED value for any routes advertised via router 1. At this point, it's only the 10.16.0.0/16 advertisement. Once done, it would mean that the route table at Alice Springs changes, since the MED value for the route received via the Brisbane Router 1 increases. It's seen as less preferred, and so the route via Router 2 is more preferred, and so it gets used for any traffic moving from Alice Springs to Brisbane. Now, MED is advertised to neighbours only. It's not transitive. So while Brisbane would be aware of the MED values from Alice Springs, Adelaide would have no awareness of the MED values advertised from Brisbane. Alice Springs wouldn't forward on the MED within any routes it advertises to Adelaide, which are received from Brisbane. And this makes sense because MED is only useful between two systems which have multiple connections to each other. There's no benefit for Adelaide to know any MED info for Brisbane, since it's something only used between Alice Springs and Brisbane. If Alice Springs had 2 links to Adelaide, then it would make sense for Adelaide to be aware of the MED values from Alice Springs and vice versa. So that's multi-exit discriminator, and it can be used to influence how your neighbour sends traffic to your autonomous system. Now, before we finish up, I just want to cover a few points around the topic of does this matter for AWS? Well, it does. AWS recommend to use local preference to prioritize a specific DX connection for traffic leaving on-premises towards AWS and use AS path prepending to get AWS to preference traffic so that it comes into your site over a specific direct connect. AWS also set an MED value of 100 for any VPN BGP sessions, meaning the default value of 0 for any DX learned routes is always prioritized. And this is why you can use a BGP-based VPN as a backup to a direct connect, because this value of 100 is preferred less than any of the routes learned over the DX. Now, if you're using a virtual private gateway for both the Direct Connect and VPN, then these use the same autonomous system number, and so MED works fine. Now, it's worth noting that if you do use a transit gateway in your architecture, then potentially you've got different ASNs involved in your BGP architecture. Different ASNs mean that MED won't be used to select between different advertisements unless you use the BGP always hyphen compare hyphen MED on your customer routers. So this is really important to understand, and I have seen this on the exam. Now, at this point, though, that's everything I wanted to cover in this video. It's just been a bit more of a deep dive into local preference and multi-exit discriminator, known as MED or metric. At this point, go ahead and complete the video, and when you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in another video.